श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। This is the second lecture in the series of lectures that we have organized here about consciousness and its application in various technologies. And this is the third lecture, if we include the ETH lecture also, the mind-boggling, confusing, a great, highly distracting lecture in which initially a floody throw of a special system, a very solid and mysterious dimension of science which the people have heard of a little or they have never heard of when it was just thrown. It was just considered to be an aspirant demanding experience. And the second, it was organized here with a broader view comparing with other technologies also. The more you hear, I think that it will be simple and sweet. And how many of you participating here in this conference, whether you have participated in the previous conference or not, that is not known to me. And even if they have participated, how much they are going to recall those things and connect with the present proceedings, that is also something very debatable. But still, I think that as it is a third lecture, certainly it will be more simple, shrewd, sharp and sweet, comparative. So let us start with the idea of understanding the concept of global design of epistemology, the knowledge design. They consider two designs of knowledge. One is nothing and second is everything. And while considering this abstract base of knowledge as everything, it is in Sanskrit known as pujya. Pujya means that which is the substratum of everything. Second is shunya, that which is devoid of anything. So nothing and everything, shunya and pujya, they are one and the same. The quality of something being devoid of anything, that denotes the presence of everything in a special standard or a special setup. So there are two stages, that which is tangibly having everything, that which is in subtlety, which has nothing which we have seen in tangibility. So if it is nothing, that does not mean absolute vacuum or emptiness, that proves that tangible nothingness. So on the basis of these ideologies, there are four stages. Number one, the most primitive or primeval stage, where everything is very similar, where everything has no difference at all, that is known as sukshma tama. So in the basic level of perception of all ingredients, whether life matter or lifeless matter or epistemological stuff, whatever it may be, at the time of there was a beginning accepted by science as well as philosophy, where everything was equilateral, equipotential and equistatus in nature. Then in the period of evolution, there was a second stage in which that was subtler in the form of subatomic particles like nano, femto and pico particles which we are studying now. These type of nano, pico and femto particles, they are subatomic in nature, that's why they are known as subtler. These subtler particles, they expose lot of behavioral differences in the form of disparity in identities, identity among disparities, mutual adaptabilities and heterogeneity composite functional ability. So when particles of this layer are read, they are capable of identifying lots of disparities in identities and functional conjugational abilities. Then the third level is the subtle level, is the atomic level of study, which is well known to most of the people. It has been well exposed, atomic study is well exposed. The fourth level is the peripheral view which we are doing now. So we have to understand two points. Before the extremely tangible state, and as well as when compared to that of the extremely subtler than the subtlest primordial stage, there is a stage wherein by the infinite inherent potential and structural standard of different types of matters can be well understood and organized. One side is extreme tangibility, which is subjected to optical vision. One is extreme subtlety, which is subjected only to transcendental vision. In between these two things, there is atomic and subatomic studies, and atomic studies have been exhausted. Now we are in the era of subatomic studies, we are the minutest particles of the same atomic levels, like I have already told friends of nano and pico. So in this study, we have to understand how things can be united, how things can intermingle with each other and create a composite development in the issues of the global functioning. What are the issues of global functioning? Energy, health, exploration or expansion of possibilities in migration and settlement. So innumerable possibilities are there, which are endorsed by science and its development. The major thing is two. One is the energy to work, and second is health for our external and technical functioning. Health required for the technical functioning is known as energy. Energy required for biological functioning is known as health. So these type of major two things, apart from that of these major health issues, it is also red with the possibilities of expansion. Expansion deals with colonization, space exploration and various other issues. So taking these issues as the instantaneous, immediate or remote considerative issues for the development and peaceful, harmonious and prosperous settlement of the mankind, this type of unison of the middle way, it is known as midway gate. It is in between the tangible and the subtlemost studies. So these two things, that is atomic and subatomic, between the subtle and the subtle level of studies, they are considered to be the study of the era. It is considered to be the exploration of the time, which is where we have to maintain various other things, take care of the crisis, also to govern various qualitative and quantitative struggles that we are facing in this world. So considering this, the Shastras, they give a very clear hierarchy of understanding these issues. One is Chaitanya. Chaitanya is consciousness. What is consciousness? What is cognition? What is intellect? What is intelligence? What is acumen? What is caliber? These things are very much confusing, but they are very simple. For example, consciousness is the basic quality of knowledge. Knowledge is to be aware of, and to be aware of what we are aware of, to have an extensive journey of exploration into the deepest zones and regions of the things that we are aware of. So, to be aware of one's own self, to have an extended awareness of the things which are around us, to have a deeper extensive understanding of each and everything based on their actions, inaction, reaction, interaction, counteraction and impact or consequential study, understanding of Buddhi, structural and functional modeling and existence. So this is consciousness. Consciousness is the all-pervading, all-knowing, immanent, inherent, multi-poly-dimensional and inexhaustible in nature, which governs everything, which is common with a lot of people. But depending upon, there are two limitations. One is the exposure limitation, second is the spatial limitation. The consciousness level of the physical elements like black,